recent years, we get more drought in different parts of the country. If you combine that with high wind, it's just a recipe for large-scale fire. Embers, they are one of the major things that get houses ignited and got the fire spread from one house to another and one location to another location. This is a kind of a fundamental research to the first step to understand how different the fuels they generate the fire brands, and like how fast they generate, the fire brand generation rate, the size, the mass, and the numbers of fire brands that they can generate, and also how far they can travel at a different wind speed. This project is sponsored by the Joint Fire Science Program. We worked with a team of researchers from different universities, from IBHS, from the US Forest Service, and also the Fire Protection Research Foundation. On campus, we did some small-scale tests, the thermal properties tests, combustion properties tests. For large-scale fire burn generation test, we did that at the IBH Research Center.
We go to IBHS facility down in South Carolina. It's just a great facility, huge. It's really cool to see something full scale and actually get some hands-on experience there.
This is a wind tunnel facility. We conduct research on natural hazards that have a wind component. So we do wind research, hail, wind and rain, and wildfire. Part of the goal with this project is to understand the hazard of wildfire. We are looking at common vegetative fuels that would be in the wildland, so trees, shrubs. We also incorporated palmetto. And then grasses. In these series of experiments, we don't have the large building in the chamber. We have small mock-ups of parts of a building. Or a small tree or, you know, vegetation that we are igniting in a consistent way, and then collecting downwind the embers that are produced when these things burn. We want to understand how these materials can generate embers, but then how the ember generation is influenced by wind. We want to collaborate with the university in general, and because UNC Charlotte is so close to us, and because of our interest in fire and UNC Charlotte's program in fire, it was a really good fit.
So my work is more specified towards the actual ignition of foam insulation, whether it be in the walls or attics. If they were to be under attack by a fire and they were able to penetrate into the attic, we are going to test the ignition characteristics of those fire brands against foam. We created our own fire ember generator, which is composed of just a steel frame where we can actually put the actual fire brands, and a burner underneath where we can apply constant heat flux. From there, we get the ignition of our wood samples. We'll transport it then over to the foam insulation, and from there, we'll obtain the data. As a student, I really enjoy doing the research, both small scale and full scale. It definitely helps to further our understanding of what we're learning here at UNC Charlotte.